morning vlog. My port is still healing pretty well. I feel like a bit more tugging from, I think, the stitches this morning, or maybe because it's healing. I'm still like breaking out in hives though, so I'm gonna try to take a shower because they actually told me I could shower because they put this cool glue instead of Steri-Strips so that it can get wet 24 hours afterwards. So that's fun, but you know what isn't fun? My laptop. It's completely lost its mind. I deleted all of the old vlogs, right? Because that's just what a person does. And it decided to do me a favor and recover said vlogs. So it's like in the background constantly trying to recover these deleted files. So uploading today's vlog, 54 minutes. And it's actually taken, it's been 40 minutes since I started it. My computer is old. It needs help, majorly. So we might have to take it to like a computer dude and see if the computer dude can figure something out, because I don't know what to do. But today is just probably gonna be another boring day. Oh, 53 minutes now for the vlog to upload. So much faster. Anyways, another boring day. Probably gonna play some Skyrim. Probably gonna watch some movies and continue to scratch every part of my upper chest because it's itchy.
Well, I was a little bit hungry. For some reason, I wasn't, okay, I don't experience hunger, I was just not in pain and a little bit shaky, so I thought my blood sugar was probably low. So I went to get a boost, and these things are only 4 ounces. I drank about 1 ounce of it, and then the nausea from hell hit me. So I had to take a Zofran, and now I have a heating pad to help with the cramping. Now I feel miserable, and I feel really sick, and ugh, I hate gastroparesis, it's the worst. We're hoping with the IV fluids, since last time I got them, my stomach seemed to function better, that the IV fluids will help with my gastroparesis symptoms and I'll be able to eat more.
So yeah, as Bethany was saying, when she was on her fluids for about a month in like December, she was getting them 3 times a week. And they were really helping, so she could eat me under the table after fluids. Like we'd be there for 3 hours getting fluids, and then right afterwards she'd be like, I'm gonna eat your arm off if you don't take me to get food right now. And then she'd eat more than I would, so it's kind of crazy. I'm kind of looking forward to it because it's really hard seeing her like drink an ounce of something that's supposed to be gentle on your stomach and easy for people to have, and getting super nauseous and not being able to finish it.
All right, babe, you ready for your list of things to do?
Yes.
You got to put the laptop away. You got to put the thingamajig there on the thingamajig. You got to put the... you gotta put the, you gotta get the pillow from my bed and put it over there so that it's like a sitting up pillow. Mm-hmm. And you gotta set up Skyrim.
Okay.
And make sure the AC is running because I turned it off, but turn it back up to 70. And also, can you check on Gus and see if Gus has enough food, because Gus needs some food.
Do I get to
kiss you? No. Part of taking care of me is Nate has to do a lot of, things. On a normal basis, I could do some of those things like feeding Gus and setting up Skyrim and things, but right now, since I can't use my wheelchair, I don't really have the ability to do much. I mean, I can like walk for very, very, very short distances, about every 2 hours, and that's about it. So Nate has to do a lot of things, and I think probably the most difficult job out of all of that is that I'm constantly forgetting the words. I have really bad word recall, so he kind of just has to learn what I'm saying based on what I'm pointing to and what it is we're about to do. I'm going stir crazy, so we're leaving the house to get some lunch. I know my stomach's feeling really upset, but I was hoping I could eat something. And guys, look at this. I am using my port pillow. I'm so excited. I don't think you understand. I got this from a charity in December, I think. This lady that gives them to people for free if they're gonna be getting ports. And I messaged her and I told her I was gonna get a port in January, which at the time I thought was 100% true. I even had it scheduled, the doctor had said they were gonna do it. And then the surgeon found out the port was for IV fluids and canceled it like literally a week before the procedure, when it had been on my schedule for like a month. And it was like heartbreaking. I was so sad, I couldn't even look at the port pillow. I had my mom like tuck it away. I was like, I can't even look at it. It's just too depressing for me. Because I was getting so much sicker and I knew that I needed this port and I needed the IV fluids, but the doctor basically told me, we're not gonna try anymore. Like, we don't even think you need this because the surgeon said you don't think you need this. And honestly, the doctor had no idea what even POTS was, so go figure, they weren't willing to give it to me. So I don't know. It's just a big accomplishment for me now to actually be using it and to have the port. And I'm so excited. Are you so excited?
I'm so excited too.
I'm so excited, guys. So I'm icing my port now. I'll admit it's like a little bit more sore today than it was yesterday. I think it's just like maybe a little bit more irritated or something. Anyways, I'm icing it to decrease inflammation. The funny thing is my port's supposed to have these like three little dots around it so you can know where to poke in the middle, and like you cannot see those dots at all. And I'm hoping it's from the inflammation and not because I have annoyingly large, but it might be from that. I'm hoping it's not though, because then it might be really difficult to access my port and then I might have to get poked a lot and that would suck.
You're a large chestal region.
I was trying not to say that, babe. So ice.
And we're back to playing some more Skyrim, trying to keep us from being too bored, so.
I'm still bored anyways.
She's hard to entertain sometimes.
Guys, I am so bored. I've done everything I could to entertain myself without overexhausting myself, and I'm very limited on that. I had a mini photo shoot with Nate though, so check out these adorable photos that we took. Now I'm gonna try to crochet, which I keep trying to do that, and what happens is my heart rate gets super high and I start feeling like I'm gonna have an anxiety attack, but it's not actually anxiety induced, it's just caused by my heart rate being so high and making me feel so like fluttery, I guess, in my chest. Not really fluttery so much as like tight. What are you doing, Nathaniel? Standing there with my crochet stuff. He's gotta bring my ring splints, which I gotta make a video about those sometime, and my crochet stuff. Wish me luck, hopefully I can actually do it this time. And we're watching Prison Break because one of my bloggers that I follow mentioned that, and like Nate was like, let's watch it because it has people with tattoos and I love tattoos, as is obvious by my tattoos. All right guys, so Nate left and I'm just editing the blog. I'm pretty much on my own now. I mean, my mom's here obviously because I have 24/7 care, but it's a lot easier when someone's constantly in the room with me. So now I have to like call my mom from across the house if I need to go anywhere because I still can't push my own wheelchair. But yeah, I'm just editing the vlog. It's gonna be up a little bit early today because I'm going to take my computer, hopefully, to a computer repair guy tomorrow and see if they can maybe fix the issues I'm having with iMovie and get it to run a little bit faster. So with that in mind, I'm going to be using an iPad to edit my vlogs until my computer is fixed, which should hopefully only be a couple of days. But if there's any weird editing or I don't do cuteness of the day because I don't have the right song or something like that, just a heads up, that's why. Hopefully I'll get fixed. And with that, I think I'm just going to end the vlog today so I can post it up and get some sleep. So I will see you guys tomorrow. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed today's vlog. If you did, please be sure to like and subscribe to my channel. Good night.